Today we have Art. He is here to have his knees injected. How long have they been hurting you?
Oh, goodness. They've been progressively getting worse over the years, so 4 or 5 years.
Usually you have space between the bone of the upper leg and the lower leg, the femoral condyle, the femur, and the tibial condyle. You normally have this space, but on your medial or inside legs, there is no space. It's touching. It's osteoarthritis. The normal little cartilaginous disc that's there is just worn down, gone. So we're going to give you an injection into the knee joint space while your legs are hanging there. Now you happen to have, this is kind of interesting.
I have a fibril.
Yeah, you have fibroid. A little, you do have a little lipoma or fibrous growth that's kind of in the way of the way we normally would approach the knee. Let me see if I can get above it. Am I hurting you by pressing?
No.
You know what, we're going to go above it. It's not going to be a problem.
So what is that?
It's called ethyl chloride, and its only job is to evaporate. And as it evaporates, it makes you very, very, very cool. So it allows you to, you know, say, there it is, you can see it. Finding my place next to the patellar tendon, underneath the patella, going into the knee joint. How are you feeling?
Barely,
okay. So I'm putting in a lot of anesthetic. It goes in very easily because we're not in a tendon or something we shouldn't be in. I'm gonna put in the cortisone. Methylprednisolone is what we're using. Finish with the... And that's it.
You know, I could barely feel it.
That's my spot, and I'm going to give a shot right there. Goes oh so smoothly. How are you doing with this one?
Okay.
And then I put in the cortisone. And then finish it off with lots of anesthetic, because anesthetic's good. And this is what's going to give us the immediate results. So I'd like to have you right now get off the table, get on your feet, and show us how you move.
Just walk?
Yeah, just
feels good.
Can you tell the difference? Did it hurt before and it doesn't now? Is that
because that's what? Yeah, it really feels very loose.
Okay. In a good way, I hope.
A good way.
Yeah. This relief that allows you to walk without pain now, the anesthetic wears off, it goes back to hurting like it did, and then in the next days to no more than a couple of weeks, the cortisone kicks in. Mm-hmm. We may have to repeat this. We can repeat it once every 4 months. And then we really do need to refer you on to the surgeon if it's not adequate at that point. You know, eventually, you know, you're not continuing to get the relief for the full amount of time to talk about other options. And they are coming out with new treatments for it. Mm-hmm. Any questions you have?
No, I don't think so. Okay. I think we've discussed it before.
I do need you. It's very unlikely. We've not had it happen, but keep an eye out for signs of infection. If there's increasing pain, redness, swelling, fever, great pain with movement of the joint, we've never seen it, but those are things to look out for that can happen with this procedure.
Okay.
So anything else you want to say to the folks at home?
I just appreciate the fact that we can do this.
All right. So thank you for joining Art and myself. Until next time, this is Dr. Mark Vaughan telling you to stay in good health.